It's time for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares, our Wiz from Another World, David Oliver. From We've Got It Made, Terry Copley. Nedra Volz. Again, from We've Got It Made, Matt McCoy. Leah Ayers. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Your motor is running. Hold everything here.
Catchy, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. Listen, you're a wonderful bunch. Aren't they great?
Terrific.
Good. They're going to get better as we go along here. You're going to get better.
Theme song. Can you hum the Match Game Hollywood Squares theme song?
Hum. Go ahead. sorry. Listen, let's get started here by saying hello to our stars with a brisk round of applause. Hello, stars! This is your first shot at it, right? Welcome, David.
Thank you very much, Gene.
Yeah, when'd you fly in?
When did I fly in last night?
Yeah.
Actually, this morning, I got in at 12:05.
Really?
Yeah, I didn't get any sleep. I won't tell you what I did.
Okay. All right. You all ready down here?
Sure are.
Ready to go?
All right. Listen, Matt, keep your hands off this fat lady, okay?
This one here, right?
Just leave her alone. All right.
You're a tough man, Gene.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Yes, we'll have to send you to summer camp and do something about your body. But right now, let's play the Match Game here by saying hello to our two civilian players here, Anne St. John and Stephanie Ulrich. Over here. Hello. Let's get acquainted. Anne, tell us about you, please.
Hi, Gene.
Hi.
I'm an ex-marketing executive for several companies, but I'm now in business for myself.
Good.
It's a business I share with my boyfriend, who's a magician.
Really?
We do magic with chickens.
No kidding. I don't think I want to hear about this.
You do, you do.
I do?
Sure. We do all the things that people do with showgirls, we do them with chickens.
Really?
Yeah.
Live chickens.
Wow. Live chickens.
Yeah. Where do you do this?
In shopping malls and club dates and organizations.
All right. And good luck to you here.
Thank
Stephanie,
you.
Please tell us about you.
I'm a full-time student at Cal Poly Pomona, studying pre-veterinary medicine in hopes to getting to Davis someday. I'm a part-time checker at a grocery store, and I enjoy outdoor sports, and I played college softball.
I hardly understood a thing you said, Stephanie. You study veterinary medicine at Cal State?
Cal Poly Pomona.
Cal Poly Pomona.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard to say. I can understand that. All right. Here we go. You'll each have three chances to match as many of the stars as you can. The one who's done that most often will be the winner. And that person will go on to challenge a returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. All right. Anne, you won the toss. You go first. You want A or B?
A, please.
All righty. This is it.
Boy.
Ben said, when I picked up my date, I knew it was going to be a wild night. Oh, I knew it. As soon as I picked her up, she had a blank strapped to her back. Mind like a steel.
I've been working on it for years.
Yeah.
John, how are we doing?
Oh, God, I'm on. Okay. And St. John, about ready? Here we go. Ben said, when I picked up my date, I knew it was going to be a wild night. She had a blank strapped to her back.
A motorcycle?
That would make it a wild night, would it?
That's a lot of back.
Yeah, I guess the audience is not
that's
too thrilled with your
back.
Response. I'm not crazy about it myself, but I'm just the middleman here between
it.
Them and her here. What do you say, David?
Well, the only thing I can think of that women strap to their backs are Indian women who strap papoose.
A papoose. I knew it was going to be a wild night. She had a papoose strapped to her back.
Babies. She wanted to make babies.
Yeah.
Motorcycle's looking better and better.
That's right.
Okay, Nedra. Well, there we go again.
What's
mattress.
Mattress. Major, they know a winner when they hear one.
Those are my people out there.
That's right, they're your people.
Yes.
Speaking of people, what have you got for us?
I said monkey.
Hey, monkey! Ah, that's a familiar phrase.
Kinky.
Now, wait a minute. There's a touch of humor there.
Touch.
I got a monkey on my back.
Yes.
Have you heard that phrase?
No.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. It's going to be a wild night. You had a blank strap to your back, John.
I said a bed.
A bed.
Yeah!
Very good.
But her answer was good for a woman who does magic with chickens.
Right. Leah.
Nidra, John, and I were in the same room, anyway.
I said pillow. All right. Close enough. What came to your mind, Matt?
What came to my mind, we won't go into that, but... this girl is wild. We have to keep that in mind here. I said parachute.
A parachute, right. That would make a lot of fun again.
Huh?
Well, you're getting the hang of it now.
Good.
Let's see what we got for Stephanie here. Linda said last night, Jimmy tried to prove how strong he was. We had a flat tire, and he jacked the car up with his blank. Having trouble up here?
Gene, I'm having a lot of trouble.
Having a lot of trouble? I can't help you. You need a clarification or a spell. That's very good.
You think so?
Sure, either one of them. You can sell the other one. That's good. Excellent. All right.
I stole my answer.
Okay. Now we're all ready to have a go at it over here with Stephanie. Linda said last night Jimmy tried to prove how strong he was. We had a flat tire, and he jacked the car up with his blank.
His arms.
His arms. How'd he do that?
Hold it up.
Oh, he just did it that way, huh? Okay, David. She said with his arms.
It's almost an arm, and it's a stolen answer, but I won't tell you from whom. Pinky.
Pinky. Good response. That would really require a great deal of strength to do with your pinky, right, Nidra?
Well, first I had nose, and then I wrote pinky.
Yeah, well, be tough with your nose, wouldn't it, there?
We do things the hard way.
Hello, Terry.
Hi.
Hi.
I said thumb.
Thumb is another good response, because that would be very... Don't boo her. I don't care what she says. Don't boo her. You understand? How can you boo anyone who looks like that?
It looks like a jack.
What's he that? Well, we're talking about two different things here. He jacked the car up with his what?
Now, wait a second.
Yes.
I could easily jack up a car with my nose.
I know you could.
Want to see?
Yeah, bring the car on. Bring the car on, Gene.
Bring that car that's a prize on some other show. Get it in here. I'll jack it up with my nose. But I said pinky.
Pinky seems to be the answer, Leah.
Well, no. I said knee so that he could use his arms to change the tire.
Knee, uh-huh.
No,
well, he rested the car on his knee. Oh, there's a little logic to that. That's not bad. Okay, Matt?
This guy's strong.
Very strong.
He's very strong.
Powerful.
I said teeth.
Teeth, uh-huh.
Very strong teeth.
Very strong. So there we are. No score at the end of round one, but you're just getting the hang of it. You'll score later. Right now, we've got these commercials for you.
Buzzer presents another profile of an African-American great, George Odin, one of the top graphic artists of his time. George was chosen to design the Emancipation Proclamation Centennial postage stamp. He also created iconic works for Goodson Todman game shows, and in 63, shared his secret on TV.
We'll show the audience another achievement of yours. Yeah,
right. Keep watching for more of our salute to Black History Month, right here on Buzzer.
We all know
Time App today.
All right, here we go. Since we have a tie and she went first last time, Stephanie, we asked you to go first this time.
B, please.
B, please. Seems like it's been a long time between questions, doesn't it? Beverly Hills is so ritzy.
How ritzy is it?
Not bad. I'll tell you how ritzy it is. They don't have mud wrestling. Instead, they have women wrestling in blank. That's how ritzy it is. A ritzy place. When, let's see now, today is Tuesday.
Yeah.
Do you work every day on Another World?
It depends. It depends on if you're in the heavy storyline or if you've got sort of a back burner storyline.
Are you in the heavy storyline?
Right now, I seem to be in the heavy storyline.
You are in the heavy storyline. For those of you who are not familiar with it, he precedes us on NBC just prior to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour with Another World. All right, here we go, Stephanie. Beverly Hills is so ritzy, they don't have mud wrestling and said they have women wrestling in blank.
Gold dust?
Gold dust. Ooh. Not a bad answer. All right, David, she says gold dust. What do you say?
I almost said that. Does that count?
No.
I said diamonds.
Diamonds? Well, gold dust, diamonds, that's all good. Nidra?
Whipped cream.
Whipped cream, another good one. And probably that would be a lot of fun, Nidra.
Wow. I love it.
Hey, what do you say we get a big spritzer of whipped cream and...
Stay away from me, Jane.
Oh, hello.
I just realized how silly my answer is.
You have a silly answer?
Join the club.
I don't care.
I said champagne.
That's a great answer.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well, they drowned.
It's wrong?
They drowned.
Oh, they drowned. Oh. Yeah. And it would sting in certain places, too. Okay, Terry. John, what have you got for us?
That's not a silly answer. I'd wrestle with Terry and champagne anytime. But I said mink.
Yeah. Stephanie's looking for gold dust. Leah, what do you say?
I said mink, and I didn't even look at John's answer.
Right. Mink.
I feel great.
Yeah.
No, I looked at hers.
All right. Matt?
I think Terry is on the right track with champagne.
Champagne. See?
They drowned.
Well, let's see what Ann is going to do with this one now. So far, it's zip to zip, but I'm going to stick with it in spite of everything. Carol said, my stockbroker is so dumb. Very good.
Yes, they're improving.
So dumb, I told him to invest my money in oil wells, and he invested it in blank wells. Do you understand me?
Yes, I did.
You're thinking? Oh, that's it?
That's
ready,
not it.
Leah. Now,
Ann. Yeah, I'm ashamed of you.
Carol said, my stockbroker is so dumb, I told him to invest my money in oil wells, and he invested it in blank wells.
I hope it's ink wells.
Ink wells is good.
Oh, wow.
Is that okay? That's an okay answer. Very good, right?
That was a very good answer.
Yeah.
It's very good.
When he turns red, I know he has got a rotten answer. Look at how red he is.
How red am I?
Yeah, he's so red that, hey, there's a question. Go.
I said wishing.
Wishing? Oh, no, that's not a bad answer.
That's not a bad answer.
That's very good, David. Good one.
What else?
Oh, yes. Yay.
What else?
Boy.
What else? What else?
I am so happy because that's one in a row now. Okay, Terry.
I said Orson Welles.
Orson Welles is good.
That's it.
Orson was quite good. Ann is looking for inkwell.
Yes. Is it my turn now?
Your turn.
Good. Because I shall serve no answer before it's time.
Oh, God.
Orson Welles.
Oh, good.
We've had quite a few of those. Leah?
Yeah, I'm so glad Nidra said this because I was going to say inkwells, but I figured it wasn't a good answer, so I said water wells.
That's better.
Well, water or ink or anything dumb like that would be good.
I put Orson Welles also.
You did Orson Welles.
That was
all right.
Matt,
there we are at the end of round two, and Ann St. John has forged ahead. 1-0 to score. Round three, final round, right after this. Hurry back.
At talkabouttd.com.
Third and final round coming up. Now, Ann, you're ahead. You have to go first.
A B, plays.
Tough decision.
Well, it is.
A or B, right. Who plays? Everyone except Nidra. Gloria said, nowadays they'll advertise anything on television. I just saw a commercial for an electric nose blanker.
Gene.
Yeah. Hey, I
put Orson again.
Oh, I got it.
Maybe it'll work this time. What do you think?
All right.
Love that music.
Doesn't it help you think?
Good.
Maybe they can hum this part. Can you hum this part?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, catchy. Audience walks out of the studio humming this song every time we do this show. Hello. Who's up? It's Ann. Gloria said, nowadays they'll advertise anything on television. I just saw a commercial for an electric nose blanker.
Blower.
Blower. Okay. Blower, eh? David?
I was so afraid that I was going to get through this week without getting one answer right.
He finally did it. Just hear the cast of Another World applauding you loudly. Now, Terry, we come to you.
I said warmer.
Nose warmer is very good. An excellent answer, nose warmer. You know, they nip those things. I just saw a commercial for an electric nose blanker, John.
Well, you know, country music, where guitar players, they got strummers and pickers.
Yeah.
And
I don't want to hear any more. We know what your answer is. That's enough.
In this here nose business, see, you got blowers and pickers. Yeah.
I'm a blower. I'm sorry.
You're a blower?
That's good.
That's good. Okay, Matt.
I didn't sink to the cellar as John did, and I went with blower.
All right. Four for Ann. Now, Stephanie, you got some catching up to do, but it can be done. You need 4 to tie and 5 to win. Let's see what happens here. The stadium groundskeeper said, "As I'll tell you why I fired my rotten assistant. Yesterday, he tried to blank the AstroTurf." All right, Stephanie, have you thought it over? Stadium groundskeeper said, "I'll tell you why I fired my rotten assistant. Yesterday, he tried to blank the AstroTurf."
Mo.
Mo, the AstroTurf. That was kind of dumb, wasn't it?
Mo, yeah, that was very dumb. It was very dumb. I think I can go back to the cast of Another World, and they will really cheer me now that I've got two answers right.
Aha, two in a row for David.
Thank you.
You need 3 more to tie, Stephanie. Nidra?
Mo.
Aha. That's 4-2 to score.
Mo.
Mo. Score is now 4-3. John, one more, we'll tie it.
I was going to write Larry, then I was going to write Curly, and then Shemp I thought of too, but instead I settled on Mo.
Thank you.
High score. One more will win the game. That wins the game for Stephanie Mo. Here we go. Right over here, if you would please. I'll get back to you in a moment. Anne, what a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
We're going to send some gifts your way from the Match Game. Anne St. John, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Bye. Well, we congratulate you. And now, see the rest of the set coming in here, flashing away there. We're going to bring on 3 more celebrities from back here in a moment or so. I'll switch places with John. And we've got lots more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Tappan's Deluxe Microwave Oven with Tap and Touch controls, built-in browner, 10 different cooking speeds so you can program to defrost and cook automatically. Furnished by Tappan. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Our quiz from We've Got It Made, Bonnie Urseth. Gary Berghoff. From We've Got It Made, Tom DeLonge. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
I'm underdressed. What am I doing here? Okay, you come right back. Maybe I'll change.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Green.
Today, happy buzzer birthday to incomparable game show host Bill Cullen.
Okay. All right, welcome everybody to the second half of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. And here is Stephanie Ulrich. That is you. She mowed the AstroTurf. Well, it's turf for me to say. And she mowed that AstroTurf to a neatly manicured victory in the Match Game and is now moving on to Hollywood Squares. We also are going to say hello to 3 brand new celebrities. Hey. Gary Berghoff. Wearing the last blue blazer you will see in that row. Next to him, Tom Villard. And Bonnie Urseth. Tom and Bonnie, of course, both from We Got It Made. And Tom Villard, you have a movie that's out now, correct?
A classic.
Surf 2, it's called. Surf 2. Hit your theaters very recently, actually. And it, I start out as a red-blooded American surfer and turn into a surf punk zombie maniac.
Well, that's a marvelous transition, Tom. And we'll
if
all
you
be
get
sure
a chance
to
see it. It's Surf 2, the end of the trilogy. That's the whole title.
Gotcha. Okay, now let's make the transition from Match Game to Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And the transition to welcoming our defending champion back. She has been back and back and back and back because today is her fifth day. Her name is Liz Johnson. Her total so far, $35,150. You've had a lovely week, haven't you?
Wonderful.
Yes, I suppose you've enjoyed yourself.
Yes, I have.
I think it's just about time, because it is your fifth day on the show, for us to meet your mouse. Would you care to show everyone your mouse? This is apparently Liz's lucky mouse, and it's been lucky so far. Does it have a name?
Herman.
Herman.
Aren't all mouses named Herman?
If you say so, Liz, you're a rich lady. Anything you say goes. Welcome back to Liz and Herman the Mouse. And if you both are ready, we're going to play Hollywood Squares once again. We're going to play this game until you hear the Time's Up bell. And whoever is ahead at that point, of course, is our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square that is captured by either of you or Herman the Mouse. Our champion gets to start. Why don't you pick a square and let's go.
Nidra, please.
Nidra Bowles.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
Silly old woman.
Which of these is more likely to give you heartburn, Nidra? Wearing your girdle too tight? Or making love standing up?
That's really not much of a choice. Girdle. Standing up. Heartburn. I have to say the girdle. I have to say that.
She just has to say wearing your girdle too tight. Liz, agree or disagree for the first square?
I'll agree.
Wearing your girdle too tight is more likely to give you heartburn. Okay. You're right to agree and you get the first square. That was a real torment. Okay, Stephanie, you're the challenger. You are playing O. Pick a star.
Bonnie, please.
Mm-hmm. Bonnie Ursov.
Yes.
You're an Eskimo.
I am.
The temperature.
I'm from Minnesota, and that's close.
You're an Eskimo, and the temperature is 0 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, when you spit on the sidewalk, will the spit freeze in midair, or will it be liquid all the way to the ground?
It's your kind of question, Vaughn.
Is there a ring chill factor?
I am an expert on spit, so I think it's... No, it won't freeze till it hits the ground.
Okay, she says it'll be liquid all the way to the ground. Stephanie, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It will be liquid all the way to the ground. You should have agreed with Bonnie.
I know
she comes from a cold climate. She knows her Eskimos. At 40 degrees below zero, however, your spit will freeze in midair. Try it at home. Okay, Liz. You're playing X. Make your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Gene who?
Gene Rayburn.
Oh, good.
This
Thank
is for
you.
A game win, Gene.
All right. Be serious.
If a mature cow stood up on its hind legs, who would be taller, Gene? The cow or Julia Child?
Wait a minute now. Let's see, Julia Child. Julia Child comes right, she comes right about here.
Can we bring the cow into the studio
bring
now?
Bring the cow in. Let me get a comparison here. Cow. Let's see. Now. Cow.
Will this take long, Gene?
Didn't he just tell me to be serious before?
A seminar.
The cow is taller.
Okay.
That was scientific.
Wow. According to that scientific study, Gene says that the cow on its hind legs would be taller than Julia Child for the game, Liz. Do you agree or disagree?
I'll have to agree. All the research done.
Right.
The cow it is. You are right to agree. You get the square and you win the game. And here news on this important matter. The cow is about 9 feet. Julia Child, by the way, is 6'2". Take that. All right, we're going to be back with a $200 game right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
It's a new day.
Good day.
Mark app now.
Now back to John Bowman and the Hollywood Squares.
$175 for our defending champ. She won the first game. Zippo for you so far, Stephanie, but there's still plenty of time. We have a $200 game that's being played at this moment, and you actually get to start it. Pick a star.
Nidra, please.
Nidra, once again.
My public.
Who gets more sleep, Nidra? The average newborn baby or the average senior citizen? I'll leave now, Nidra.
Well, I haven't been a newborn baby for a long time, but I've been a senior citizen quite a while. I don't sleep so hot. So, I don't sleep so cold either. I think probably a baby.
She says the baby.
I agree.
And the public agrees, and Stephanie agrees, and you're all right, because the average newborn baby gets more sleep than the average senior citizen. You get the first square, Stephanie. Good going. That's $25 as well. And you are on the board for the first time. Your move, Liz, pick a star. You're playing X.
Bonnie, please.
Bonnie or Seth? You're 25 years old. If you and your teenage sister make the same effort, who is more likely to get pregnant? You or she?
Effort, you say.
It's a key word in there, Bonnie.
I was afraid you'd get me on that one.
My teenage sister.
Agree or disagree, Liz?
I'll disagree.
The 25-year-old is the right answer. It's more likely to get pregnant. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. That is good playing.
Lucky for your sister.
The easiest years for conception between 22 and 26. Okay, Stephanie, do you have a conception of where you'd like to move?
Matt
McCoy.
Okay, I'm ready.
Laughing gas, Matt, often has a very strange side effect. Does it cause amnesia, or does it cause women to become sexually aroused?
Now, you're right up my alley here on this one, John.
You big nut.
Sorry to hear that.
I forgot the question. Could you repeat it? Oh, come on. No, it causes women to be aroused.
Okay. He says laughing gas causes women to become sexually aroused. Agree or disagree, Stephanie?
I disagree.
It does cause women to become sexually aroused. You should have agreed with Matt.
Matt,
he knows his women.
Get that square.
Yes, your opponent gets that square.
How did you know that?
Two X's up there for you. Okay, Liz, you are playing X. There are two of them up there. Make your move.
Terry to win, please.
This will win you the game once again. You can do it, Terry Copley. Which came first, the drive-in movie or the Rear Window defogger?
The drive-in movie.
For the game, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
The drive-in movie did come first. You should have agreed with Terry, and your opponent gets the square and blocks you. 1933, the drive-in movie goes way back. The Rear Window defogger, 1968. A kid. Okay, Stephanie, you're
David's
back
win,
in the game. This will win you the second game if you get it. David.
Yes.
When washing your dog, is it okay to use a blow dryer, or will that cause psychological damage?
Psychological damage. I haven't had a dog since I was a kid, but all my friends that have dogs, they treat them much worse than blow drying them, and they don't have psychological traumas. So I would say, no. Is that what was the question?
No, probably wouldn't answer this question. No, is it okay to use a blow dryer?
Yes.
Yes.
Blow him dry.
Okay, it's okay to use a blow dryer. Yeah. He says it's okay to use a blow dryer for the game.
I agree.
It is perfectly okay to use a blow dryer. You're right to agree. You get the square. You win the game. And you forge into the lead. Amazingly enough, you have forged from behind. You started this game with nothing, and now you got $275. $225 for you, Liz. We're going to clear the board right now, and we're going to move on to the next game. It's worth $300, smackers. Liz, pick a star.
Nidra, please.
Nidra Volz.
My puppy.
Which weighs more, Nidra? An African elephant's ear or the average pygmy?
Matt, you know that.
Yeah. Just talk.
Wow. I haven't tried to lift either one of them. Pygmy, those are my people. But I think, son of a gun, I'm going to say the pygmy. What the heck?
Go for it, Nidra.
Go for it.
Stand up, Nidra. I am standing up.
Don't Nidra went smart, for it and G. said that the pygmy weighs more than the African elephant's ear. Agree or disagree, Liz?
I disagree.
The pygmy does weigh more. You should have agreed with Nidra, and your opponent increases her lead. Pygmy weighs, average pygmy, 90 pounds. The largest elephant ear, no more than 50 pounds. Stephanie, you're ready on the board in this game, and it's your move. Pick a star.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Right.
You've just painted your bedroom, and it really smells. What does the Ladies' Home Journal say you should set on fire to cover the smell? Your cologne or some dog hair?
You got any other questions there?
This is it, pal.
The paint smells.
Right.
It's a malodorous experience. And to mask it, you can use either dog hair.
Set on fire, cologne or dog hair. One of these will actually work.
Or the dog's cologne.
Yeah. Well, if you go to a drive-in movie, you have to have a rear window defogger.
It has to be blow-dried dog's hair, though, Jim.
That's right. Well, obviously, if you set the dog hair on fire, the unburned hydrocarbon particles, which is smoke in effect, will cling to the drapes and to the wallpaper and stuff, and therefore, it will mask whatever odor of the paint is there, and I believe the dog hair would do the trick.
And not long ago, this man was imitating a cow. Stephanie? He says you should set dog hair on fire to cover the smell of paint. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should set fire to your cologne. You should have disagreed with Gene. Your opponent gets that square, and we get to come back and finish our $300 game right after these messages. You get to come back, too.
Here's another clown buzzer.
Okay, it's really a tight one. 300 so far for Stephanie and 250 for Liz. We're in the middle of a game. The game is worth $300. There's an X and an O up there. Liz, you are playing X and it's your move.
Matt, please.
Matt McCoy.
Come back to the money, huh, Liz?
You got it. Thank you.
Matt, you're a woman with a large bust.
Right.
Should you be able to swim as fast as a flat-chested woman? Or will they slow you down?
You know that one.
I think I swim faster than Terry.
Would you like to do a little research on this before you answer the question, Matt?
I've done a lot of research on this already.
Oh.
I happen to know this. They will Good. Slow you down.
He says they'll slow you down, Liz. Agree or disagree?
It's so crazy.
Trust
I'm going to agree.
Trust me.
They will slow you down in the water. Okay, right to agree. You get the square. Okay, two X's up there now. Stephanie, and you are playing O. Make your move.
Leah, to block, please.
Mm-hmm. You missed this one. The game belongs to our defending champ.
But they'll slow you down.
Leah Ayers, you're a flamingo. Are you born pink, or do you change color later on?
It would sort of be nice to be a flamingo. You change color as you mature.
Agree or disagree to block, Stephanie?
I agree.
You change color later. You're right to agree, and you do block. And that keeps the game very tight. Flamingos are born off-white. Okay, Liz, she's back in it. Make your move.
Tom, to block, please.
If you miss this one, then the game is won by Stephanie.
This is very important.
It really is, Tom. It's too bad you're wearing that jacket for this moment. Tom Villard.
Yes?
What's older, Sophia Loren or foam rubber?
Oh.
It's a,
Sophia
rubber's
Loren
made out of rubber,
rubber,
right? That sure, I know this. Yeah. I think, no offense, Sophia, Loren is older. I think, yes, definitively speaking.
Agree or disagree to block Liz that he says Sophia Loren is older than foam rubber.
I agree.
Foam rubber is older than Sophia Loren, and your opponent gets that square, and your opponent wins that game. It's pretty close. It's close. Sophia Loren, 1934, foam rubber, 1928. The bell means the time is up. Our new champ, $650. What you have to do is go over there, join Dean Raver, and get Cynthia Scott enough big money. Well,
I'm happy.
You're happy?
I'm happy.
You're happy?
Yes.
Are you happy because you're leaving here with $35,625?
Right. Yes.
I would be happy too.
Sure.
Had you won today, of course, according to our game rules, this would have been your last day anyway. You certainly were a magnificent champion, and you have our thanks for being so good on Match Game Hollywood Squares. Liz Johnson. And now, Gene Rayburn takes a look.
Okay, we congratulate our new champ here, Stephanie. We're going to be back with her, our 9 stars, for a go at the $30,000 right after this.
And now, here to play the Super Match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Okay, here we go. Liz Johnson just left here with $35,425. We're all happy for her. And now Stephanie's going to have a go at the big money now. She can win up to $30,000 right here now. Shall we? Okay, let's do it. We polled a recent studio audience, said, write down your best answer to this. Short blank. $1,000 for the most popular answer, $500 if you choose the next most popular, $250 for the third most popular. Any three of the 9 stars can now offer their assistance to you. Call on them one at a time, if you would, please.
Bonnie, please.
Shortstop.
Shortstop is one.
Matt.
I have short bread.
Short bread.
Mammy little baby loves.
Thank you.
Okay.
All righty.
And David, please.
I have shortcake.
Shortcake, shortstop, and shortbread. Those are the three they've given you. Now you have to make a decision. Do you want to choose one of those answers as the one most likely to be under the $1,000 response or up there at all, or do you want to think up one of your own?
I'll take shortstop.
Shortstop. Now, from the All-American pastime. Let's find out if shortstop is under the $250 response. Shortcake. All right, that's the one that David gave you. We're looking for shortstop. Let's take a look at the $500 response. Short stuff. Who's that? I don't know. All right.
No one in this room.
No, that's true, obviously. We had a dead silence there. Last chance for shortstop. Slide the big one, if you please.
Yeah.
Shortstop. Stephanie has $1,000. Now, Stephanie, it's time to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you choose your star, that person will reveal the hidden number in front of them. It'll be a 10, a 20, and there's 130 up there. We'll multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Time now to choose a star.
Bonnie again, please.
Bonnie, she's chosen you. Grab that tab and give it a yank. Ready, set, go! A 20. That means, yes, she's powerful.
I destroyed
you. You are playing for $20,000. All right. Good luck to you. Bonnie, here it is. Blank pop. P-O-P. Blank pop. Okay, Bonnie's ready with her answer. And now to collect the $20,000, all you have to do, Stephanie, is match her. How do you do that?
Soda.
Soda pop says we'll match it to the $20,000. What do you say, Bonnie?
Soda pop.
Soda. Listen, I don't know what you had in your purse when you came in here an hour ago, but right now you got $21,650.
I have a lot of
insurance on the spot. Visit goodtogo.com today.
Okay, now we're going to find out which of the stars had the big number. So, John, would you take your seat, please, and we'll all grab the tabs and give it a yank right now. Who had it? Tom Villard had it. Tom.
Tom,
that's 2 days in a row, right?
Yeah, and you really should not have the 30 in that jacket, Tom.
Right. Listen, next to Tom is Gary Berghoff, and we didn't get a chance to talk much with Gary during the Hollywood Squares part of it, but I want to say how much I enjoyed his performance last night in Aftermath. It was good to see you back on television again. I wish you would come back on a regular basis, will you?
I enjoyed it.
Okay.
Thank you. Good to be back here, too, Gene.
Thank you, Gary. And thank you. Join us next time for the Match Game. Gene Rayburn here.
And John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar's new 13-inch portable television. Features customatic tuning, high-tech styling in a simulated walnut grain finish, and super color system furnished by Quasar. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.